my junior year on the campus of Dillon University, a group by the name of Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes. I hear you. Lead singer Teddy Pendergrass came out with a song called Wake Up, Everybody. And from the day that song came out, everybody started walking around saying, wake up, no matter what you were doing, they would just continually say, wake up. I guess they told me that a lot while I was in class, wake up. And somebody's probably saying, where is she going with that? I'm gonna do what my pastor does in church, hold that thought. Wake up. In 1942, some members of Delta Sigma Theta wrote the words of the Delta Sigma Theta Sweetheart Song. And while they were penning the words to the song, which would embody the love and soul of the words that we sing today, in the second line of She May Be, it says, she may be the dream girl of A. Fire. All right. You might have heard that before. So since my good friend and good sister of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated has already reminded you of who you are, the sisters of Delta Sigma Theta just stop by to say, wake up. Because the girls of your dreams are here. But this is a little bit special today. This is actually my last time to have the opportunity to present on behalf of my sorority to a national president of the Divine Nine. And this is really, really extra special because Barb and I not only share the opportunity to serve our respective organization, but we share the bond of being initiated on the campus of Dillon University, the Dillon University of New Orleans, Louisiana. On the campus of Dillon University through Beta Gamma Chapter and he through Beta Phi at Dillon of Alpha Phi Alpha, we stand tall as Dillon graduates, so this is special for me. So since I only have 2 minutes and I'm counting right now, I think this is your shirt. This is my shirt. And this is our Dillon alumni. I had to throw that in because we need to be proud of our historically black colleges and what they produce. I know that the words of that song, She May Be the Dream Girl of A5A, is true. Three of our founders were married to Alpha Men, Osceola, Naomi, and Vashti. And today we continue to have a special relationship with the brothers of Alpha Phi Alpha across the globe. We are honored and delighted to share with you in this meeting of the minds when you come together to take care of the work of your organization. We thank you for being around 107 years and the opportunity to welcome us with the rest of our brothers and sister organizations to the Centennial Club, as we celebrate our 100 years of service. I want to present a gift, of course, to Mark, and I, like my brother of Omega Psi Phi, I don't have any gift to wear, but I have something for you. Hopefully you can buy a lot of things to wear. It's got a couple of zeros behind it. Zero, zero, zero. It's got some of them behind that. So don't put my bag down. Carry it yourself. But in my presentation, of course, the front of the bag has your black and gold. But right underneath it, it says, in red, make a wish. And your dream will come true. Because we are, after all, the dream girls of A5A. And because we not only come with a gift, and for those of you who know who I am, I never come without leaving you some words to remember to continue the work you do. The words of that song continually tell us that we need to wake up. But there's a line that I want to leave you with. It says, the world won't get no better if we just let it be. A5A, Delta Sigma Theta, my brothers and sisters of the Divine Nine. I know we've been to college, and as my Uncle Joe would say, we all got degrees. But that line says, the world won't get no better if we just let it be. We've got to change it. We've got to change it. You and me, we've got to change it. No, 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 no. No, 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 no.